How are you? How are you? No, really, how are you? Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I am Britt, creator of The Style Shaker, your guide to cleaner, greener beauty, skincare, and beyond. Today I am back with a review for the Josh Rosebrook Nutrient Day Cream. I have the Tinted Facial Moisturizer here. There's SPF 30. I've probably added this to my cart a bajillion times and then walked away from it, and I don't know why. I really don't. So I'm thrilled to be able to review this. This was gifted to me by Integrity Botanical in conjunction with another collaboration that we did. Let's dive into this review. Let's try it out. Let's see if it's worth it because it's kind of pricey. Okay, here we go. Let's get into it. If you find the honest reviews helpful and you want to keep seeing more of them, take a minute, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you're not already. You won't miss a thing. We're going to run through the scorecard like we always do. It's 5 easy questions. And if you hear birds, it's because I'm surrounded by birds in this new townhome. So kind of cute, but kind of messes with the audio. But you know what? Love nature. Just don't put me near bugs. There is one universal tint, $60 for 1 ounce. 1.7 ounces is $90. This is the 1.7 ounce bottle. It's glass, plastic components, but glass container. Advantages and disadvantages to that. I'm happy it's just not plastic. Cruelty-free, vegan, gluten-free, and currently I don't see any refills available. I'm always looking for them. This product also has broad spectrum protection via mineral zinc, non-nano, high micron. I don't even know what that means. I haven't looked into it, sorry, but I'm gonna be honest with you. I know what non-nano means. High micron, let's look into it together and get back to each other. And there's 12% zinc oxide in here, so that's your mineral sunscreen. Speaking of ingredients, this is always the first question. I'm not a cosmetic chemist, spiel. You guys know the disclaimer at this point. However, I have read hundreds of ingredients labels, and this one was beautiful. Can I say that? It was a beautiful list of ingredients that not only did I recognize, but I could possibly eat. A lot of them were organic. There were specifications that they were non-GMO. Just because you can eat them or they're natural, I don't really like using that word, and the product, the brand didn't use it, doesn't mean they're not going to have an inflammatory response on your skin. So I always encourage you to look at the list. I over here tell you if I see giant red flags. I did not see any red flags personally, but again, what works for me might not work for you, so do take a look. The brand is really known for thoughtful, high quality ingredients. Do I have a lab in my studio where I can test this? No, I have to go on the brand, but the brand has a very solid reputation, so I can kind of see it. And then in terms of performance, you can really feel it, but I'll get to that in a second. Next up, application. So how was overall application? Is this a heavy cream? Is it a very light whipped cream? I would say it was just smooth. This is very finger friendly. You can just pop it on your face. You do not need a brush. I didn't need a brush to put this on. About a quarter size blended in well. I like to use a good amount if it's going to be my main source of SPF. If I'm gonna be in direct sunlight, I do, and I've said this before, use strictly SPF, not just like a tinted cream for that. I use heavy duty, probably 50 and above. I don't want any damage happening on the face and body, of course, neck, all the rest of it. Quarter size blended on really nicely. There was no white cast here at all. It received a 4 out of 5. The other thing I want to talk about here is coverage, and there is a universal tint, which can be tricky. I don't know if it's universal. I only have my skin to test it against. It's supposed to help minimize inflammation and redness, and I really did feel like it did that. I don't know how it did it because there wasn't sort of a cover up here or a foundation here. My skin always has a little bit of redness, and when I applied this, I saw a lot of moisture. I did see my skin sort of eat it right up, soak it right up, and the redness dissipated quite a bit. It wasn't completely covered up, but I like to say it made my skin happy. It's just something you can kind of tell immediately when you put something on your own face, I'm sure. So I saw a positive result there too. Overall finish here, so on the swatch, at first it comes across as glowy and moisturized and hydrated and felt a little wet at first. So I was thinking, okay, for the amount that I wanna put on, maybe this is gonna feel a little too dewy. It did not. I gave it a couple of minutes to just sort of settle onto the skin and was surprised with the touch test. It wasn't sticky or tacky. If it was, it was only because of the products I had on underneath or on top. The brand mentions that you can prep skin and smooth skin with this, so it's kind of a multitasker. It's supposed to smooth it out and prime. And then it's supposed to give a perfectly matte moisturized finish. So to me, I translate that as semi-matte. The priming and smoothing of the skin I did not see, although it did calm the skin, so that helps, of course. For me, it was more moisture hydration. wouldn't say this is a skin smoothing cream. Personally speaking, it depends on your skin, I'm sure. But in terms of drying down a little bit to matte, it wasn't dry. It just was this really interesting hydration that wasn't shiny. It was just glowy. It was really cool. And it's something that's very subtle, but when I see it, I go, wow, because I don't see that often. Usually if it's hydrated and moisturized, you can feel it. It feels a little bit wet. It feels a little bit shiny or dewy. This didn't have that. It just looked moisturized. And I'm gonna say it again, my skin just looked happy. I don't know what it was. It just did its thing. So overall for finish, it received a 4 out of 5. I almost gave it a 5 out of 5. Scent, super easy. It is not scented. You're not going to smell anything here. Love that. For an SPF, let's remember, it's a day cream with SPF and a tint. But if it's an SPF product, sometimes you really do smell it, although there's a lot of progress that's been made on that front. Zero scent, zero white cast. So if you're looking for an SPF 30, yet again, I was impressed. And because the scent had no scent, I gave it a 5 out of 5 on the scorecard. The wear test was great here as well. It wasn't the kind of product that you put on in the morning and then the oils of the skin naturally come out and get your skin looking greasy or slick. If you have oily skin, this could be something that could work for you. If you've tried it, let us know in the comments. Overall though, it looked just as good by the end of the day. Almost as good. Nothing's that good. I mean, unless it has 24-hour wear test, then there's crazy chemicals in it sometimes. Not that chemicals are bad, but maybe I don't want to put the ones that are in those 24-hour wear things on my face. So just trying to like cross my T's and dot my I's here. The wear test at the end of the day, it looked lovely. It hung around. The hydration stayed without looking oily. That's the point. And going out in the sun, I was out in the sun intermittently. Inside, I'm close to a window. I saw no issues. I didn't see any redness or inflammation. I didn't see sun color getting on my face. For reapplication, usually I would pat this on my hands, pat it on top of the skin, or I would use a sponge to do it, or I would just use one of my sprays, which I've mentioned in a previous video. But yeah, I did not test this in direct sunlight for hours. I don't do that over here, so just know that you're not getting that level of a test. I expect the brand to do that. A lot of them don't. This overall, I didn't see any burning or anything on the face. Also, take into account what you're using for skincare. I have been using a vitamin C serum. Retinol at night, so I definitely load up on higher level SPF. Speak to a dermatologist if you need expert advice. I am not one, but just telling you how I roll. The wear test again was really solid. Overall, I received a 4 out of 5 on the scorecard. The overall score here was a 17 out of 20. I really think I'm gonna bump it up to an 18 out of 20. I don't know. I feel like it's really close to a 19 out of 20. Anyway, it was really good. For now, it's 17 out of 20. I'm 2 weeks into using this, so if that changes, I will let you know. And now it's time for my final verdict. Would I buy it again? Well, I already told you this was gifted. So would I throw down and shell out 60 to 90 bucks for the 90 bucks for this again? It's so hard to say right now. This product is unlike any other day cream I've tried for a couple of reasons. First of all, it has a tint, but also for that mattifying finish that's hydrated, my skin looked beautiful with it on, and it's something that I would notice more so than maybe anybody else, or maybe like my mom would be like, hey, your skin looks really good. And she did that a couple of times. Yeah, I might. I still need to keep testing this. I could see myself missing it when it's gone, which is really the true determining factor for that question. A lot of products I try and I really like, and I probably wouldn't miss them. This one, I have an inkling that I would miss it and I would reinvest. So we'll see. I'm gonna keep giving it a shot, but I'm leaning towards, yeah, that's it. That's the final verdict for me. That's the personal part of this. And sometimes I'm undecided, guys. Sometimes it is. So I gotta try it out for a little bit longer. I'm just excited that I got to try it. So thank you again to Integrity Botanicals for gifting this. Have you tried this product? What do you think about it? Do you think it's worth it? Isn't that like the big question, right? Let us know in the comments below. I always love hearing from you. I'm gonna go try out some more products and I'll see you right back here real soon. Until then, bye. Oh Snapdragon by Red Apple Lipsticks. Love their lipsticks. Strawberry Cactus, 100% pure. I love their lipsticks as well. There's love for all lipsticks. This came out a little too opaque pastel for my taste. So I mix it in with kind of creamier lipsticks or lip glosses, and it adds like a warm summery pink. So I'm using it. So I'm just gonna stop now.